The Game Awards have come and gone, and with them, I was left with a very sour taste in my mouth. Don't get me wrong, there was a lot of really great moments. The Sonic 2 movie trailer was really good, the Sonic open world game looks phenomenal, and we got to see Keanu Reeves again, which is always a win in my book. But when they started actually giving out the awards, that's when I realized something that made my stomach turn. Nearly every single award had the same nominations. We had Psychonauts 2, we had It Takes Two, we had Resident Evil Village, we had Deathloop, and we had Metroid Dread. Now, originally, this list looks very good. Heck, all of these games were so good, in fact, that they almost carried this entire year of gaming alone. But something was missing. If I recall correctly, there was a game released this year that had more accolades than all five of these nominations combined. A game that had the artist behind Nights into Dreams, the programmer behind Sonic the Hedgehog 3, the publisher behind Kingdom Hearts and Final Fantasy 7, and a guy named Tomohide Hayashi, who was an additional crew member on Mario & Luigi Bowser's Inside Story. Surely a game with this much proven talent deserves at least a mention, let alone the award for the entire thing. But sadly, it was nowhere in sight. So I figured today we're gonna put that responsibility on our back and revisit the tried and true real game of the year, Baylan Wonderworld. Nice jump! Crushed it back there. Dude, that's right. The game controls just as good as I remember. X. Let's see what X does. Okay, X jumps. All right, let's see what square does. Okay, square jumps. Let's see what circle does. Okay, circle jumps. Let's see triangle. Okay, triangle jumps. That's awesome. I have never seen a game better than this, if I'm being honest with you. Start to jump. All right, let's see. Let's go one. Bada bing. Let me in. The boy who would be one with the wind. Relax, Baylan. You're Baylan Wonderworld. You're Baylan Wonderworld. They're making it sound like this game is fucking the... I'm sorry. Hold on. I'm trying to gather myself. It appears to me that there was a fan blowing upwards and a collectible above where the fan was blowing. It appears to me that my assumption was that the fan would blow me towards the power-up. But it turns out, just like in real world, the fan chopped me to pieces. Straight up to pieces. So that is impressive. That is impressive. When Halo, when the new Halo game, you can't even shoot fruits? Baylan Wonderworld has realistic fan physics, dude. This game better Halo? Top text? What I need to know is what the fuck else is this power used for? There's this funny thing that Baylan Wonderworld does where it gives you powers and all of the powers are used for one very, very tiny, very specific thing and nothing else. Who's the floating guy? That's a very good question, you know? And that's very, I'm so glad you asked. Because I was about to. Who the fuck is Mandark over there? Hey! What? You dumb bitch. The crazy thing about Baylan Wonderworld is like when you look at it on paper, this was a game that you should have actually been excited for. Like, I can't remember, I said it in my last Baylan Wonderworld video, which was forever ago, but I can't remember exactly how much star power was behind this game, but it was a lot, and I mean a lot of star power went into making this game. I can't believe this game already won Game of the Year, right? So quick. They didn't even let other games compete, actually. Not even gonna lie, they didn't even let other games compete. This game came out, and immediately all gaming companies at the same time said, this is it. Not because of any corrupt reason. It was just everyone knew at the same time that there would be nothing that can compete. I know a lot of people liked God of War, but God of War had a lot of not realism. And I think that is what kind of was a drawback for God of War. Baylan Wonderworld, it has fan that kill you when go over, and I think that specifically is what separates the boys from the men in the sense of Game of the Year. God, this game is a masterpiece. It truly is. Maybe they did it on purpose, you know? I'm not gonna think that it was a mistake, you know? The creator of Sonic, the director or producer of Sonic the Hedgehog, wouldn't make a bad game on accident, You know, it has to be on purpose. There's a deeper meaning here we're not understanding. And I stand by that. There is a very deep meaning behind Baylan Wonderworld Baylan game. And it's up to us to decipher. Look at those NPCs. You see them dancing and cheering me on? Check this out. Ready? Check this out. Ready? Someone in chat asked why. Why did they disappear? And that's your first mistake, is asking questions about Baylan Wonderworld. Maybe you just gotta take the blows as they come, as they say. That's actually a quote from Mr. Sonic the Hedgehog himself. Don't you just love when people randomly disappear? Yeah, it's so real. Like, that happens to me all the time. I go to Walmart, I see somebody that I want to interact with, and then I realize that they don't exist. The draw distance, the second I get closer, they get lower and lower resolution. I say a word, they're gone. The game is still overpowering you. Is it actually? I'm gonna turn it down again. Jesus. I don't know why the game is so freaking loud, but whatever. Let's go. What is this power? Holy shit! What? I just get a gun? Did he just do the robot? Can we get an instant replay? Did he just do the robot at me? Did he just fucking crush it? Did the main character of this game just want to show us that he used to be a fucking pop locker for the majority of his life, and now he's ready to start blasting? What, man? I don't know how to react. I don't have it. I don't have the reaction. Oh my god. They refused. Hold on. I need to explain this to you guys. They refused to give me another button to blast. So now he just blasts all the time. Check this out. The only button is jump. They didn't want to program two buttons into the... He's just blasting. I feel like a father who wasn't allowed to see his son for years. So now he's just like, son, I'm doing my best to be a good dad. I wasn't able to be a good dad. I want to be a good dad now. I feel like that's how I feel playing this game. It is... I don't even know if it constitutes as suffering. I just cannot explain to you what I'm feeling right now. Baylan says, peace was never an option. Agreed. It wasn't. And then he did the robot. I like how he went, all right, let's kill some monsters. We gotta kill some monsters. All right, let's get it done. You know what I feel like? From all those weird, awkward dance animations that are in this game, you know what I genuinely feel like? I feel as if they didn't have the time to do the animations in this game, so they went to one of those websites where you could download CG assets, and they found a bunch of random mo-capped dances. Yo, is this a cutscene? Look, they're all dancing. Look at me interact with them. You know what that felt like? It felt like the people who they hired to do the dance, they had somewhere to be, or the company who hired them couldn't pay them to do the whole dance. So they went, all right, one and two and three, goodbye, guys. It feels like that's what happened. You know, the game's not... It's not a como se dice good. It's not good by any stretch of the imagination. Hell, I wouldn't even say it's great. Or even passable at that rate. But still. What do I gotta do here? Oh, I know what I gotta do. They both gotta get hit at the same time. So I gotta stand right here. Whoa! Scooch figured out that puzzle. That's insane. I figured that out. You saw that? You guys saw my giant brain there? Figure out that basic platforming puzzle? Are you shocked at how big my brain is? You wanna know something crazy? Like, honest to God. Besides A Hat in Time, I don't think I've seen a single good platformer come out of anyone that's not Nintendo. And I really wonder about it. When it comes to 3D platforming, it seems like the only game that did well in like the last decade besides Mario games would be A Hat in Time. Everything else has just been fucking atrocious. That is adorable. That is cool. That is actually pretty awesome. That giant whale with the cogs. God, this game screams of brilliant design and then just being thrown to the side. Like, I feel like they had so many ideas for this, and then it just got destroyed. It feels like if Spirited Away lost its budget on the second day of production. That's what it feels like this game was going to be. Ukulele, dude. Poor Ukulele, man. Poor, like, you want to know what sucks? It's like, as much as I want to say, oh, poor Ukulele. Poor Banjo-Kazooie fans. It did the thing where it thought the old formula can just carry it. And obviously that was not the truth. Your old formula that worked on the Nintendo 64, God knows how long ago, is not going to work when the Xbox 360 is out. You know what I mean? Like, that shit just does not work. There were no games that have come out since then, or since, I guess, Mario Odyssey, besides A Hat in Time, that I constitute as a great platformer. Oh, let's do another cutscene that's disjointed from the rest of the game. Whoa, a Balin's bout. Let's see what happens here. Freaking rocks. That's all he's doing. In the lowest effort 3D environment I've ever seen in my life. All he's doing is breaking rocks. There's no reason for it. He has no reason to be breaking these rocks. Good. Whatever. Good enough. But he does look cool. Yeah, I'm not going to take that away from him. He looks good doing it. Yeah, that's true. And then that wink. Is there something I'm supposed to know about, Balin? Okay, I need to keep going that way, I think. So how the heck do I get that way? Do I really have to? Whoa! That's actually pretty bussin'. Yo, that's good. Okay, that was cool for a second. Let me explain it. Because I thought I was going to have to get on this and then ride it to that mountain and then go through that mountain in order to win. But if you jump on the whale, then you just win. Most exciting thing in the game was a 10-minute cutscene, right? Didn't it whet your whistle? Did it not whet your whistle? Is there a story here? Ready? Check it out. So let me explain the story to you. Green hair man throw airplane, right? It's a very real statement because green hair man always want to throw airplane. And so green hair man, happy that he throw airplane, he run down side of wall because green hair man realize he can throw airplane. And therefore green hair man make bicycle that can fly, eat shit. Green hair man then sit and make another bicycle that can fly, eat shit yet again. Green hair man try one more time. Eat shit again. And then he make another... He's just fucking it up. Green hair man now gets scooch hair and has a bandage on his hair. It's actually a deep story. It was so hard. It was so hard to explain it to you because there's a lot of pieces that you gotta turn over. But basically, long story short, green hair man won't fly, green hair man can't fly. Is story of Balin Wonderworld. And now, somehow, monster exists. But before we get into this boss fight, did you know that the majority of the people watching this video aren't subscribed? We're releasing content daily right now, and I think you would have fun if you just subscribe to the channel and don't miss a single banger by ringing that bell as well. I love you if you subscribe. I love you if you don't. Now let's get into that boss fight, which is good. Oh my God, the boss fight. It's too much. How am I supposed to react to any of these moves? Okay. All right. Okay. And just like that, I hit him in his face. I popped up and I shot him in his shit. Oh no! An undodgeable crazy demon attack. What am I to do? Oh shit. Those pieces. What are you gonna do, sir? You think you're gonna kill me? What if I shoot you in the face? What if I roll up and I shoot you? Wait! He's doing a super secret booty blast technique. Oop. He got me with the old Balin's concussion, huh? Pretty good play. I should have seen the Balin concussion coming. Bro, I need a lock on your nose. I'm trying to punch this guy in his stupid nose. It's not letting me. Thankfully, I have infinite lives because falling doesn't kill me. What? I want to shoot you in the nose, dude. But this homing attack, it doesn't work as good as the game devs thought it would. There it is, I guess. There we go. Bada bing. It is truly the Dark Souls of rock destruction. Agreed. It is truly the Dark Souls of rock destruction. Now here it comes. Crazy man. Crazy man's about to do some super secret attack that's going to make this game good. He's going to do the goodening attack. He's going to do some crazy hell sweep that's going to make me go, oh shit, I was wrong about Baylan all along. There it is. His hell sweep technique. There's no way to reply to it. There's truly no way to come back from the hell sweep of death. I know the game is... I'm supposed to be able to use those balloons to get to his nose. I am. I'm supposed to be able to use those balloons to get to his nose. But it doesn't work. So I'm just going to cheat the game by just jumping off the ledge and mashing any button on the controller. And now, continuing the story we were talking about, that Baylan Wonderworld is about. You see, so Green Man, come out, demon, plane monster, happy. And so, kid walk up to Green Man hair. And they shake hands. And the most important part of Baylan Wonderworld is busting down. Wait. This is it. Holy shit. He's one of the Wright brothers. What? He's one of the Wright brothers. I like how that says fighting styles and doesn't explain itself. What? What? So if dance with kid, you fly copter. Exactly. Exactly. You're getting it. Maybe I'm dumb. Because it can't be that anything's wrong with this game. Streamer doesn't know. By the way, there is a lore book for this game. Is there actually a lore book? I feel like it would be easier to decipher League of Legends lore by playing a game of League of Legends than it would be from beating the one player only single campaign of Baylan Wonderworld. These kids want to eat. Who am I to say no? Yeet. Eat, my children. Finally, some good food. Craig is the MC in here because he likes dancing so much. Let's go. The only reason he became the main character is because he's a dancer? Bro, you had enough. All right, young man? Whoa, these guys are getting big. Is this supposed to be the Chao Garden? I think it's their attempt at a Chao Garden, but... You see, what's wrong with it is that it's not good. The problem with this Chao Garden specifically is that it's not good. Eat, my homies. Eat. Whoa, that one got big too. I got two big chickens now. And one more for whoever's hungry. Now let's go do this one and then let's go do blue. Unlock the second section of the Island of Tims. How do I do that? I don't know how to do it. You don't tell me anything, video game. You tell me nothing. You just go, hey, Scooch, welcome, Island of Tims. Figure it out, you dumb bitch. But we can honestly say, without a shadow of a doubt, that that's because the game is good. It's deep lore. It's like Dark Souls. You got to figure it out through context clues. World storytelling, exactly. The same way Dark Souls does it. Are you telling me you can't understand that I turned into a sheep in order to kill a giant plane monster? Come on, pay attention. Keep up. Keep up, Chief. Look at him. Hey. Look at him. Chonker's coming over here to grub down, I think. Well, I guess we can say, without a shadow of a doubt, that this is the game of the year.
And the 2021 game of the year is...
Baylan Wonderworld, Baylan Top Text, Baylan Bottom Text. Yeet.